West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider, no you don't want nada.
Riding on this, dude. This is a big fucking reunion.
When
dude.
Do we go?
Where do we go?
When? Start.
Start. We're good. We're in.
Hey.
Dude. How you doing, bro? How you doing, brother?
Good, man. It's good to see you.
Yeah, man.
This is Serpentine. I am in crystals now.
Shit, dude.
That was my big bit. It's done.
It's good.
That bit's done, dude. It didn't work the first time.
It worked.
The reunion is here.
The reunion is
upon us.
Lit, dude.
And we keep trying to work, but these goddamn hipsters we fucking hired to help us. Do you have fun doing the job that you have?
Yep.
All right. What's up?
Chilling, dude.
Phone's off. Matt, how the fuck are you? What's been going on, dude? What have you been up to in the last month? I have not seen you.
Dude, I know. It's weird.
It's the longest time we've gone without seeing each other in probably 5 years.
Yeah, it's fucking bizarre.
What the hell's going on?
Dude, I've been doing nothing but deep spiritual research, as you have been as well.
Well, this is very, very deep stuff.
That's how you get it. You got tapped, basically, dude. Someone tapped you. A woman, you said, accosted you.
No, she was just a voodoo woman from Louisiana that came to my show.
Really?
And she said, do you feel like God is sending you on a mission?
What'd you say to that?
I said, we were taking a picture and I was like, all right. That's how I responded. And then she gave me this and I was like, oh, nice. Thanks. And I was like, this will be funny to bring to the podcast to show Matt that I'm on crystals.
I think it's totally normal.
That I'm on crystal now.
Something funny, you know?
This is nice to rub.
Sure.
And I am getting worried that I maybe do have some type of, I don't know. It's nice. It's nice rubbing.
It is nice to rub.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. We're
so
all
there are benefits of rubbing rocks.
Yeah, we're fucking, yeah, we're, you know, we're all just energy. Crystals choose to be crystals, by the way. I don't know if you know that.
This decided to be a crystal?
Mm-hmm. It's a mineral, but not all minerals take their crystalline form. And the only thing scientists can't figure out why some minerals end up becoming a crystal.
So
they're self-organized.
So the answer we've come up with is they must have decided that because we don't know it?
Yeah, exactly.
Hmm.
There's the way they shape. There seems to be some sort of self organization. So yeah, dude, crystals are, you know, they're no joke, dude.
I think this is a fucking joke.
What? No, dude, crystals.
No, I'm not gonna let this thing go.
I mean, I wouldn't put all your, you know, eggs in that basket. But they're definitely.
I hope this thing takes control and organizes my life.
It's what if it was like the mask?
Somebody had it.
If you start smoking, dude, someone has to stop you.
If I start smoking, the government's gonna have to shut this down.
True.
They're going to have to stop me. What happened in your life in the last month? Are you mentally preparing for your big day?
Dude, I'm just walking right into it, man.
That's coming up.
It's coming up in like 2 weeks.
Woo-wee.
I prepared for it by telling myself I have plenty of time, and now the time's upon me. So
we should have, you guys, this is a mistake. This
why?
Television and Google.
This is a great
this
idea.
This is a mistake.
This is a great
we
idea.
We can't afford this.
What?
Mentally, we cannot afford this. As soon as I was like, you're excited for your big day? Gardini Googles marriage. And now there's just marriage
well,
pictures.
Well, I will say I've been having reservations about
marriage
interrupting. But no, marriage is nothing.
Hey, there's Matt. Yeah, bottom right. That's a big day.
Well, the thing is, dude, I'm kind of fucking, I don't want to. I'm trying to figure out how I can have this marriage but not like disrespect black love. You know what I mean?
Yes.
It's like, it's important. Black love, it's important, you know, the whole idea of sticking with your own kind.
Yes.
But, you know, only for, you know, not for white people at all.
White people.
Not white. White love is abominable. But I don't want to disrupt black. I don't want to ruin like a black love. I want to come up with a good black love story. So that's why, you know, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Better not disrupt black love.
I might Tropic Thunder is what I'm trying to tell you. I might. Bro,
if you walk down the aisle. Yo, if you walk down the aisle.
I just want a black love, dude. I just want a hashtag black love, dude.
And stop with the Google. Is that what you've been doing? Have you been instructed?
Gardini's been Googled. No, he's been Googling just the most random.
The topic?
The whole Shaner was talking about sex, and he was playing, unbeknownst to Shaner, Kissed by a Rose in the background.
Oh, that's funny.
It's pretty funny. Nice. Shaner's talking about like eating buttholes and stuff.
Of course. Shaner's so cool and horny. Nothing more than I love just a guy who's good at sex and is horny.
Yeah, man. Telling you, that's a I might just wear that exact outfit.
Do you take this one?
Or
I do. Or slip one of those in for me, would you? During one of the vows or whatever, just be like, I do.
I do.
And the rest of them say it normal. They'll be like,
I do. I'll try to remember that.
Am I giving a speech at this thing?
Yeah.
Oh no!
You roast, dude. You have to roast me.
Can I share it with?
Yeah, you guys can go back and forth. You guys can go back and forth.
Love is kind.
You guys can be like Styles P and Jadakiss, dude.
True.
Just go bar for bar. Yeah. Or what I might do, I might have the nerve to do a full Tropic Thunder. But what I might do is just steal Valor. I'll just put like a military uniform on. Second best thing,
bro.
I'm a fucking troop, dude. If I stole Valor, I'd probably a fucking Marine.
Do both. Get
just,
like
just go a
very expensive, well done blackface.
And then you
like very well done, like Robert Downey and steal
and
Valor.
Then steal-
I might steal Valor.
That's the whole groom party has to wear.
If I can't
like,
get to Men's Warehouse in time when I get back, I'll just buy a military uniform. That'd be tight.
Dude, slip into the old. Do you still have the old guard?
Or jeans and tee. Should I just go Louis? Everybody else in a suit,
dude. If you showed up in like a military uniform,
I definitely still have.
You still have your stuff.
My mom definitely kept that.
Toss it on.
Some type of weird shame.
Yeah,
sadness.
Toss it on.
Yeah,
you should wear that exclusively in the house of your parents.
My mom keeps that stuff like a. You know when people's like kids die and they don't touch the room? That's what my mom does with like all my old West Point stuff. She's like, he could have been an officer.
I mean, bro, put on the gear. What happens if you were a troop? Goggins went, you could probably get re-enlisted or just wear it and show up to the Pentagon in the parking lot and just be like, hey guys, I'm back.
Check what the records. Yeah, I'm signing back up.
What do we have going on?
God damn it, I'm in. You guys asked for me. I'm back. Now, what do you want?
You're allowed to wear it. Can you wear that garb?
Yeah, I could technically.
Yeah, technically, yeah.
Technically.
And just go to Annie's at the
technically,
mall?
Technically, yes. Technically, I was honorably discharged.
Yeah.
I swore in and was honorably discharged.
What the hell?
Technically, I could wear.
Could you please
a West
be decorated
Point
cadet at my
uniform?
Wedding?
Yeah.
Can you please be decorated? And it's going to be at a place like a military place. So
oh, they'll like it.
State, but yeah,
they'll respect that.
Hell yeah.
Hmm.
You should. I'm telling you, man.
Maybe.
I'm going full. I'm going to be in a 5-star general outfit. I'm going to look like the dude from what the fuck's Twin Peaks? I'll look like the general from Twin Peaks, dude. I'm going to be. Lightning fast. That's a dark chalk, bro.
We're a little rusty.
That's dark chalk, bro.
We're a little rusty.
So that's my plan, dude. In order, I don't want to, you know.
Are you going to cry?
I was thinking about it, dude. Yo. I'm writing my own vows. So
oh,
I was reading them today. And the
I
last,
might fucking cry if you
yeah,
write your own
the last,
vows.
Last little bit gets me choked up, dude.
Really?
Yeah. They're pretty
Is
sweet.
It about your sweet baby, Maya?
Not even. Not, oh, nice. It's not her day, dude.
Good.
It's not her day. I don't want her anywhere on the premises.
Your child.
It's not her day, dude.
That's good.
So, yeah, no, she'll be, you know, we'll probably just leave her at home. She's old enough now where we can just.
She can handle things.
I thought about that, man. We were in a hotel weeks ago. Like, we went to Chicago last week. Surprise fucking shower, bro.
Mm.
Dude, that was a nightmare.
That is a nightmare.
Just, that's the ultimate, like, when are we doing? And it's like, we have lunch. She's like, lunch reservations? I didn't think it through, too, because I'm like, wear something nice. And I was wearing jeans and a t-shirt. She's like, I was like, they have my clothes at the restaurant. She's like, what?
Oh, man.
And I was like, dude, just relax. And then her cousin's like, yeah, actually, like, stall for another half an hour. And I'm like, I can't, dude.
You cannot.
I can't stall for another
what
half an hour.
What was she hitting you with?
just being like, I don't even want to get, what is this? And I'm like, Sig, why would you take me to a nice lunch?
I love that even before the ceremony of your wedding, you're still like, if anyone's like, what was she doing? You're like, like, without a second, you're like, what was going on?
I told her, she has an ally in you and my, she goes, I hate the way you impersonate me. And it's like, dude.
It's wildly disrespectful. Although I was just doing my girlfriend, like,
she was genuinely sleepwalking. She was genuinely sleepwalking.
God damn it.
That's how it sounds to me, dude. I do it all the time.
Of course, that's what it is, dude.
We do the blow by blow. I'm like, we get into the territory of like, I'm like, yeah, but then you were like, and she's like, this I said, and I, oh, the worst is when they go, no, I was like joking with you. And it's like,
yeah, you can't joke.
You,
it's not your strong suit.
Yeah, dude. You don't joke.
Funny jokes.
And you don't get up early.
They can't get up early.
They're in a daze, dude. They're on autopilot. They're not there.
The babes are on autopilot?
They're all wearing Calvin and Hobbes glasses.
They are drones.
Before 8 in the morning. Yeah. It's just ping pong balls, dude. They're fucking...
Yeah, they're drones. And they're mad. They're so mean all the time. Dude,
it's crazy.
My girl and I have been together long enough that she's starting to be able to be mean for no reason.
Yeah, man.
Like, for no reason. I'll call her and be like, you know, you talk about how hot young girls are all the time. And I'm like, don't listen to my podcast. Yeah. She's like, are you a fucking pedophile? I'm like, what?
Oh.
Is it the young babies, dude? I'm not allowed to talk about Google. Honestly, young dude, hot girls.
You
please.
start to appreciate.
Don't.
You start to appreciate.
Don't Google young hot girls.
After a while, you start to appreciate their little fermentation periods.
Yeah.
Like you'll start. I'm telling you, with enough time and patience, you'll start to know. Like you'll be having a discussion, and this is they'll start to do a thing where they'll go. Maybe I guess dudes do this too, but it's like you're bringing up a very valid point, and then they start talking louder and faster.
Yeah.
And, you know, it used to get me and I would talk louder and faster. Now I stop and just go, if you're getting angry, we can pause.
Mm.
Like, let's wait till we're all, you know, I'm not fucking angry. You know?
Well, that would drive me up a fucking wall, too.
Well, you can't.
If you and me were fighting and you were like, do you want to talk about this when you've calmed down?
I don't hit with that. I just go.
I'll fucking cry. I'll cry right now.
I don't hit that necessarily. And I'll get.
I'm nervous.
I'm nervous.
I'm scared. Show me who you are. You went samurai on that kid immediately.
True.
I mean, full.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Just right away. Like, where's your honor?
Yeah,
put your mask on. Show me who you are.
Yeah, dude. That would have been beheaded. Back in the day in Japan, that was just.
Yeah.
Right. You were just cut. You were like, you would fume and then go, wait, what am I even arguing?
Why would I even talk to
cut
this
guy? Then you would, that was all the matter. You'd be like, is this guy from a good family or can I cut his head off? Yeah. I'm like, oh, fuck, I can cut this guy's head off.
Yes.
Dude, I was reading about the Ainu people in Japan.
What were they up to?
Ainus?
Hold on. Before we get to the Ainus, what was the thing we were just talking about? Because I liked it.
Oh, the...
ladies?
Lady spazzing. How you can diffuse bomb. It's diffusing a bomb.
It's not. You cannot.
You can't have shaking
It is the
hands.
Hurt Locker.
But dude, you start to appreciate.
Can we insert these in the video so they know? All right.
They'll be popped in. You start to appreciate, dude. I'm telling you.
That's her. That's my girl every night.
Yeah, you're
saying, motherfucker. What happened? She's like,
she walks.
She sleepwalks.
She sleepwalks.
And sometimes we sleep naked. Well, I always do, but occasionally she does. So I'll wake up in the middle of the night. She'll be standing naked in the room in the dark.
Damn.
I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? She's like, get back to sleep. Dude, she's a demon.
And she's long hair, don't care, too.
She's scary.
What do you say? Someone's got to get that girl a harmonica.
Yeah, I said somebody ought to get her a harmonica.
So you're bad. You're dealing with nocturnal.
I'm dealing with an absolute nocturnal, so absolute
I'm telling
demon.
You, dude. So you're...
And then she wakes up. She's like, I'm sorry, last night.
And like, that's just storing up another nocturnal fucking
It's a nocturnal
explosion.
Emission.
She's emitting nocturnally. She's emitting rage nocturnally. You guys might have to go out together in the woods and scream. Just go out in the woods and just,
I screamed.
You should just.
I screamed into a pillow when Notre Dame lost to Cincinnati. Notre Dame lost to Cincinnati. I've never been more angry.
What the fuck?
Dude, I was so fucking mad, dude. In a hotel.
It's like, dude. Remember we heard the guy having sex?
Yeah.
People probably walk by and heard you.
They're like, damn, that was me fuming, dude. Notre Dame, Cincinnati. They stunk. It was the worst game I've seen in a long time.
Who else did they lose? The Eagles. Just the Cowboys.
Eagles
just lost
stink. I was at the Cowboys. I was at the game. I went to Dallas Cowboys,
what?
Dude.
Fuming,
at
dude.
The Cowboys Stadium. just around. But you know what's nice?
Yeah.
The Dallas Cowboys have what we have here, which is like the Eagles fans.
They have, you know, like, what I mean? Dickheads.
They have like dickheads.
Yeah.
And not to be racist, they tend to be black dudes that are dickheads. So
may those two groups never meet,
the,
dude.
The Cowboy fans from Philly and the Eagles fans. Holy shit, dude. If they united, there was a dude. So right away, the Cowboys drove down the field and scored. Then the next possession, the Cowboys made a stop, get the ball back at their own 1 yard line, fumbled in the end zone, and the Eagles scored a touchdown. And there was a dude a couple rows in front of us, this black dude, just standing up. Eagles jersey, fuck all you guys, fuck you, like screaming in people's faces.
Damn.
And then the Eagles proceeded to get fucking destroyed. So they that was the one touchdown they scored, and it was like in the first minute. It was great.
It's like a 1 yard line fumble.
But yeah, it was fun to watch.
Yeah.
You wouldn't like those Texas people.
Really?
I didn't like it. It's a very, very cool, nice stadium, but they're all like Texas. Dude. They all wear fucking cowboy hats. Although I have been wearing a cowboy hat.
I've seen it.
It's powerful. It feels good. Yeah,
dude. It feels really good.
Feels very good.
You start putting on a cowboy hat and you look at Mexico and you're like, that should be ours.
What the hell are they doing in my state?
It should be ours, dude.
I'd like to be there.
Dude. Yeah, I've seen you in that cowboy. You look good in that cowboy hat.
Thanks, man. I look like that. Click that. It's exactly what I looked like.
Yeah,
cowboy
dude.
Pants are tight. You ever wear those Wranglers?
No,
they are fucking skin tight.
According to my mom, I'm okay because I wear stretchy jeans.
You wear stretchy jeans?
Yeah, I wear stretchy jeans, dude.
I haven't seen that.
I mean, you can't tell, but yeah, these jeans are all stretchy. As soon as I found out that was an option, I had to get talked out of wearing the fake sweatpants jeans.
That's awesome.
That was my move, and then it was like, nah, you can kind of tell.
Who talked you out of that?
Brittany was like, you can tell. I was like, I was coming to her like, dude, I can wear them to dinner, and she's like, no, they're obviously sweatpants, and I was like, fuck.
That's funny. That's exactly what I looked like.
Yeah, you looked good in them.
That was like the outfit, too.
You looked fucking good in them.
I filled out a cowboy hat. I got a big, dumb, fat head. Perfect for a cowboy hat.
State trooper, right?
I should have brought it. I was thinking about bringing it. I should have worn it for the podcast. You look good. So I was doing all types of bits.
You were in
Serpentine Rock. I had a cowboy hat.
You're a prop comic.
I was ready for the podcast.
You're a prop comic.
I am a fuck you, dude. You can be my opener. See, I am a prop comic.
That's pretty good.
I might have to stick to props instead of that.
Dude.
Can I keep going? Or maybe I'll bottle it up. Anyway, hats off, dude. I'm still going.
God damn, dude.
Nah, I got to stop. I'm going to phone it in.
God damn, dude.
That's pretty good stuff.
What the fuck?
Yeah, I'm retarded.
Dude.
I've been rubbing this rock and my autism is in bloom, dude. It's the whole time I've been accusing everyone else of being autistic.
But when
you watch a Notre Dame Cincinnati game and scream into a pillow and then you're quiet the rest of the day, something's wrong.
I will say when I was watching your podcast so I could steal all your jokes and use them here, talked about dogs and cats, that I was like, that's pretty fucking good.
It's a good bit.
That's
thanks.
Very funny. That's very funny.
Thank you.
That was very funny. I was like,
I've been trying
that.
To figure out how to use that in stand-up.
I'm going
to
steal that and use it.
It's tough. I did it last night at the Cellar. It's tough to get into that.
Yeah, you need to build up to that.
I literally just have to say, listen, this is going to sound bad.
Which is funny.
It's not.
Which is fun.
Yeah. But that can't be how every joke I do starts.
Yeah.
Which is how they are. All the new stuff I've been doing, which I was pumped for. In Louisiana, that was the first weekend I did since the special came out. And I was like, I got to do new.
Yeah.
And I did. I did like 45 new. Just, it was great. But
awesome.
But because it's new, every joke requires like.
Little disclaimer.
This is new and it's not good.
Yeah.
People with Down syndrome are like dogs. They got to try to explain it.
Well, you got to put it in context. But look, I was on a podcast.
Edit that out, please.
Look, I was on a podcast. It's a good comparison. And you're talking about in terms
cats
of like
dogs.
The loyalty.
Fun, excitement.
Amenability. Yeah.
Yes.
Versus the fucking...
The autistic cat.
Yeah.
The very autistic cat where it's like, I love it. Does it love me? I think it loves me.
It'll ignore you for like
two days. It'll just walk out of the room while you're talking to it. It doesn't listen. Like, get up here. It's just... Like, all right, are you mad?
But yeah, dude, to answer your question, bro, I've been up to fucking... Nothing, bro. I've just been... doing the pod every week.
Have you been beating off? Have you been looking at pornography?
No, man. I've been very, very sparingly. And it's only if like...
Why did you say no?
Yeah, Guardian, back me up.
Because I've been doing it too much and I was trying to lie to myself. And
you're
like,
cutting it
oh,
off.
You have not been beating off.
I'll tell you what.
No, or you have been.
I have been too frequently.
Beating off rules.
Beating off
one a day?
Yeah, one a day.
Two a day?
Every once in a while.
That's bad.
I'm like one a week, bro. If that.
One a week?
I'm 50%. If I pull up a phone and pull up porn, what happens to me a lot now, I pull it up, I scroll the options, and go, you know what? Never mind. I don't want to. This is, I don't want to see.
You know what was nice?
Bunch
my lady.
Of oiled butts.
My lady was with me for most of that trip. So that's I was nice. Not whacking off. That's and then nice. As soon as I got back to New York, I was like, I'm so excited to whack
you
off.
You got to whack off.
Yeah, I got the beat off. I got the whack off.
Yeah, that's pretty nice.
Whacking off for the first time in a month is great.
Well, I mean, I was in for that. You know,
just a no pressure ejac. Usually when you're having sex with a lady, there's some level of like,
I'll back you up on that.
This is going well for her.
Yeah, I'll back you up on that. No,
and
I was.
You get to just lay back and be like, I hope my roommates don't hear. That's my only concern.
Of you jerking off?
Yeah.
You guys all know each other pretty well by now. Yeah,
at that point, it wouldn't matter.
No, I was describing my sex life on the page with Lemaire and Beezer and Shaner.
I'd like to hear more about it.
It's just hand jobs, bro. It's that's, just, and I work,
fucking wild.
I work hard. No, it's a good thing. I work hard, dude.
It's a good thing.
I work. It's the best. I work hard. I stay focused. And then I just, you know, every like couple weeks, I just save it all up and just catch like an epic, like eighth grade level hand job.
Mm.
It's pretty sick. It's like usually on a Saturday morning.
I do hear you on this. And dude, I actually do like the idea of this.
Get the coconut oil. White dude, I don't even bring it up. She goes, get the coconut oil. She grabs me. She gauges. She goes, oh, look at that. First of all, it's annoying, too. She'll do this thing where I don't use that Kirkland crap, dude. I use Dr. Bronner's. There it is. The is that unrefined? I use unrefined, too, brown label. But the that was fucking calling the
shots. Unrefined.
But yeah, dude, that's been the that's been my preferred mode of sex. There it is. That's the fucking dark label, bro. What the hell?
So she just
there she is, bro. Whole
scoops
curl.
It.
I scoop. Because only scoop. I know enough. I know how much.
You scoop.
Girls always underestimate the. I'm like, are you serious? Even with the lotion is bullshit. It dissipates in like 2 seconds.
Up.
That I'll tell you what about that Dr. Bronner's, bro. Mm-hmm. That stuff, your dick will be greasy for a while. Not Vaseline level. Vaseline's too much.
Yeah.
Vaseline's almost. That's like, that's
you
issues.
Try
dude.
Butter.
Butter would be fantastic.
Butter would be great. I bet.
Dude, some ghee.
Yeah.
Some ghee.
I don't know what that is.
Clarified butter. It's when you boil butter and skim the shit off the top and turns
it
into
it would be
ghee.
Wild.
Bro, butter would be nice, man. Can you type in ghee as a masturbatory lube or butter as a masturbatory lube?
I mean, everybody's whacked off with butter, I bet.
I never have.
I never have either, but I mean, it must be up there. Because I'll get butter on my hand and be like.
Yeah, dude. Butter would be. Sometimes I touch a mango. Sometimes I touch a mango. Think about rubber band and a couple of those. You get like the inside of a mango. Oh, boy. You should definitely not. What the heck? Marlon Brando did it in a movie, apparently. And it was triggered a bunch of people to
think it's
cool. Ew.
Which.
Oh, I'm talking about masturbation.
Oh, for sex, yeah. Well, you don't want to shove dairy up a lady's pussy.
Why? They do it all the time with yogurt.
Yeah, but what?
they do that. Every their last bite of yogurt, women put in their vagina.
Really?
Just to get some bulgaris. Yeah, some L. bulgaris, dude.
Mm, no, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah,
no,
dude.
You're kidding.
Yeah, the
women's vaginas are disgusting, and they can fall apart at any moment.
Yeah,
if they're just constantly
they go down,
sick,
they go down,
and there's yeah. I don't know how they work at all. There's problems.
They go down. There's a lot of problems that can pop up on them. It's not everyone thinks. Oh,
dongs, you can ignore any problem. You can just let it ride.
Oh yeah.
Say whatever this is going away, yeah. And I'm not going to tell any of my sexual partners about it.
No, you grit your teeth through a little bit of burn. You're like, I got to drink more water.
They're going to catch whatever this is. Yeah. Because I'm not telling.
Well, I don't think dudes transmit sexually transmitted diseases. I think only women transmit them.
I don't think you're that far off.
I think only women transmit
yeah.
them. Dudes really, they can only get them from women.
Some
then,
people report using yogurt in the vagina as a lubricant and treatment for yeast infections.
What? Look at that.
How do you know something like this?
I was just kidding, bro. I didn't think they actually did that.
You've never been a part of a lady being like, and one for you?
No.
One for me? Oh, Jesus.
I didn't know that. I also, I had a theory that women can get yeast infections from eating too much sugar.
That I'm sure that's the case. Look at those fleshlights. How to clean your fleshlight like a real pro.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Are these?
Whoa. Mouth fleshlight? Fuck?
And it's all sweaty and shit. Just a like a perspirating fucking nose.
Oh my god, dude. Get rid of this. This is fucking.
Yeah, what the hell, dude? Ew.
Number one though, man.
Coconut oil is loot, bro. Come on, man.
So you get whacked off with coconut
every
oil
every couple weeks. Yeah,
fuck,
I save it up every now and again. I'll, you know, again, like you said, sometimes the sniz just goes down from, you know, things happen to it.
Sniz does fall apart.
It goes down
once a month. Well, not just the period, but there's always like the period, and then like I'm about to get my period, the thing's a fucking mess.
Yeah,
I just had my period. It's like something else is wrong.
Yeah, there's, you know, there's things that can
disgusting
pop up.
Dude, women fucking suck. Yeah. Edit that out, please.
Yeah, dude. The but yeah, so I've been doing, and I like once a, I do it on a needs basis. Like I try not to do it just because I want to. But like if I,
you mean sex?
No, masturbation. Well, sex even too. Yeah, I don't. You know.
You try not to give in to your needs.
I only do it if I like feel as if like I have like I. There's a feeling I get when I have too much cum in me, and I do it purely as like, let me just get this out of me. Unless really? I'm making a child. That's the only time I do sex enjoyably.
Then you're making a child.
If I'm making a child, I'll fully let my guard down and enjoy sex.
Mm.
Other than that, it's pure maintenance. I resent the fact that I have to do it at all, to be honest.
Nice.
It's annoying. I don't.
You don't ever do it out of like personal insecurity, and you want to prove your self worth by having sex with someone.
Beyond that,
it's almost exclusively that was, why I have sex.
Well, that was exclusively my that was the nature
like,
of my,
I am the man.
That was the nature of my sex life forever.
Yeah,
of course.
You don't only hook up with girls so you can tell your friends you did it.
That's all. I just got pussy for my boys my whole life, dude.
My whole life.
That's all I wanted.
If it weren't for my boys, I would have.
I'd be asexual.
Chilling.
Yeah, I'd be asexual. It wasn't for the pressure of my boys to constantly get pussy.
Yeah.
And then tell
somebody
them
else would be like, yo, I titty fucked this girl. Fuck.
Yeah.
Why am I not titty fucking people?
True. That's something nobody does anymore that needs
TFs?
To be fired up.
Yeah.
Titty fucking. Is that a young man's game? Is titty fucking a young man's game?
I think so. I think.
I titty fucked like a month ago. It was sick.
Yo, really?
Yeah, dude. It was so cool.
What type of lube was in there?
Just like regular like lube.
She used lube to titty fuck you?
Yeah.
Whose lube was it?
It's mine, bro.
What are you doing with lube?
What the hell?
Titty fucking.
Why didn't she use yogurt?
True, I should have. I know now.
What so you titty fucked?
I titty fucked.
To completion.
Not to completion. No.
That doesn't count.
No, that's it's like that seems like way too hard.
That'd what? Be a long thing.
Yeah, no, it's a long
You're
time.
You're jerking off too much, dude. If my dick touches tits, I'm coming immediately.
I guess so.
What the hell?
So You titty fucked.
I titty fucked for a little bit, yeah.
Yeah.
Did you like?
Were you laying down?
No, I was on top. She was on her back.
Ew.
I was
your big
over
stinking
top,
butt
bro.
Was on her.
Ew, big stinking butt was in the air.
Do you hold the nipples when you titty fuck?
Yeah, dude, you have to.
No, you don't.
Wait,
how'd
nipples?
You, how'd you
well, no,
nipples?
Like, well, you,
yeah, you hold a nipple.
You go
horse's
like,
reins.
No, you go like under and grab. You know, like a,
yeah,
like,
you gotta push them up.
Yeah, push them up. You gotta push
and
them.
And then
together.
You go.
Yeah, absolutely.
What were you saying while you're? Did you say anything or was it silent?
No, nothing. I was just breathing heavily.
Yeah, you can't talk during sex. Talking during sex
is weird.
I think the only time I talk during sex is if I'm titty fucking.
Really?
During titty fucking, I'm fucking your titties. You're fucking
look
titties.
At you fucking
look at these
titties.
Dude. Can't remember the last time I fucked me some titties. And then I name the geography and I go, man, this Chi-Town pussy's so good. You always name you name every dude. You gotta name the geography of the girl.
Of where the girl's pussy's from?
Yeah.
Dude. Man, I ain't never had no pussy like no Iowa pussy. Ain't no pussy like no Tallahassee pussy.
Dude, you got it. I that stuck. I watched this one porn one time. There was this guy who was just fucking. He's like, man, I'm used to this H-Town pussy. This is Chi-Town pussy. He was talked about the geography of the pussy the entire time. It was so sick. Chi-Town's some good pussy, dude.
Yeah. Please include that in your vows.
Oh, for sure. Chi-Town pussy. Dude.
You're Chi-Town pussy? From the day we met, I knew your Chi-Town pussy was the best pussy I've ever had, baby.
Yeah, you gotta call it. Call, I'm telling you, next time call it the geography.
Next time I have sex with my girlfriend, I'll be like, Chi-Town pussy. Actually, I'm gonna be in Chicago tomorrow with my girlfriend. For real, I actually am. I'm gonna fuck her.
I'm
Chicago.
So mad I'm in the Poconos.
I'm
too.
Gonna have Chi-Town pussy.
You're gonna have some Chi-Town pussy
tomorrow. I have Chi-Town pussy headed my way.
Where are you gonna eat?
Where am I gonna eat?
Bro, go to Burger Bar.
Pussy.
Go to Burger Bar, dude.
Burger Bar?
Burger Bar.
Burger Bar.
Chicago has, I pig out every time I'm there.
Yeah.
Everywhere I go, everyone's like, we go to the best route. I'm like, yeah, whatever. I go there, dude, and I fucking pig, dude. Burger Bar rules. It's just a bar that makes sick burgers, so.
Well, that's the problem with traveling, which I've been doing. Everybody constantly is like, dude, you got to go eat here.
Yeah.
And then you go feast.
Yeah.
Like, I was in Austin. I ate barbecue for fucking 12 days.
Jesus, dude.
Then I was in LA. LA was nice. I didn't booze too hard there.
Yeah, that makes nice, sense.
LA was a little more subdued. Well,
LA has the healthy foods. You can eat.
LA has a man healthy food. But it's very like it's not a party town. LA is not like New York. New York is 4 a.m., 5 a.m. LA, everything closes.
I was only in LA for one day and I didn't like it. I went to the LA Fitness there and it was just a bunch of male models on fucking testosterone screaming at each other. Everybody we're playing there. Basketball. Just a bunch of male models on testosterone screaming at each other.
Oh, man. How long ago was this?
Oh, dude, this was during my first marriage. Yeah. This was probably seven years ago.
Since Instagram and TikTok and everybody's internet famous now. Ugh. It's wild.
Yeah, this is like 9 years ago, dude. Yeah. I was in an LA Fitness with like, what's that show about the bartenders? Vanderpump. It was like Vanderpump. I was with like the cast of Vanderpump Rules, dude. Fucking just getting screamed at on a basketball court by Jax.
Set the pick.
Dude, it was like, what the fuck? They would miss a shot. Like, fuck.
Yeah, it is an uncomfortable place.
That's it. That's literally everyone in LA Fitness when I was there. It looks like the Vanderpump Rules cast. It's fucking crazy, dude.
They don't have any fucking Chatham pussy.
Nah, that's not that Chatham pussy. Although there's a lot of transplants in LA, so maybe it would be. True. There might be some Chatham pussy.
I'm sure there's a lot of Chatham pussy in LA.
That's some fucking England pussy right there. That's really? Some fucking great. That lady in the front, yeah, that's Great Britain pussy, bro.
That's not good pussy.
That's GB pussy. England, that guy, like great that guy to the left, I believe, got cucked by Jax. Sorry, brother. Jax is the ultimate on Vanderpump Rules.
Really?
Dude, Jax, fuck, dude. There he is, bro. Dude. Is this a compulsive? Dude, they filmed him for a year. He was a compulsive liar.
Is this a reality show?
It was a reality show that was hot during my first marriage, and I used to watch it on Saturday mornings in bed with my...
Put this hat on.
My first one. There you go, bro.
I feel like wearing a hat, dude.
You should. I actually almost grabbed one on the way out the door. Yeah, dude, Jax, he would just... It was crazy. He was on TV, and they would just like...
Timestamp this.
Film him. Yeah, the hat.
Puts hat on that.
For sure, yeah.
Edit this out. All right, so the reference there is every LA podcast I do. It's very funny.
Oh, dude.
Just constantly. Like, everybody, they'll say something, be like, hold on, edit that part, go back to the podcast.
Yeah, dude, that's crazy.
Which is great. It's great.
It's great.
It helps my anxiety.
Yeah.
Like, when I did Burt's, the next day, I had to text him, like, get rid of that. Please get rid of that.
We drank
a lot.
Yeah, that's a recipe for disaster, bro.
It got rowdy.
What happened? Did you scrap the whole thing? Or you just,
no, it actually ended up looking and or coming out pretty well. That was one podcast I was like, this one's going to be brutal.
Really?
Came out great.
So how do you hide the cuts?
He's good at it. Is it the
camera angle thing too?
Camera it's like, angle.
Because they switch camera angles and it's just like.
Yeah, or they all have ad reads. They do ad reads post.
Yeah.
So they can just insert ad reads.
Right.
Now, we're not doing that.
No.
Unless it's worth hundreds of thousands of dollars. We're selling out. I apologize. I have to sell out.
We'd have fun.
But yeah, it is funny. It's funny to like
dark chocolate.
Because they'll say wild things, dude.
Do they?
All
those
boys say something wild, and then they're just like after they're like, cut that out. Like just and you're sitting there like, damn, I didn't know you got down like this. They say something wild and you're just like, oh shit.
You should have brought your own camera and just released the whole thing.
Yeah, true. I considered just in case one of them tried to trap me.
True.
But no, because the anxiety after a podcast, I'm always like, why the fuck would I try to say that or think that was funny? And 9 times out of 10, it's totally fine.
Yeah.
Nobody ever gets upset or anything bad happens. But.
So what you're telling me, we got some thinking to do. Because you saw the real deal.
Yeah, but we're never going to be able to do that.
Cut that out. We will.
We're never going to be able to do that. This is true. Good. This is what we always wanted. This studio is perfect. The second we start dressing it up and making it look professional, that defeated the purpose. We could have had a nice studio.
This looks
fucking insane. This is bad. And that's what the goal was.
We got to switch it up.
You want to get a nice studio?
No, not that. I'm saying like we were mandated by our fucking landlord. We got to get rid of this table and we're going to have couch. We're going to have like two love seats. They're putting a fucking washer and dryer in the producer closet.
Oh, God damn it.
It took our producer closet. It's got a water hookup.
Ah, fuck.
So we'll have producers there. We'll have to sit on it. Yeah.
We can just change. We can just get a fucking studio, I guess.
True. Where though?
Philly.
Guess
why not?
I mean, we can. I don't care.
Yeah, it'll be easy. Edit this out.
Yeah, cut this.
What are these hot Vanderpumps doing?
So, dude, yeah. So you're saying you're in LA? It's not a big party town.
No, it's not. And I was expecting it to be.
Everyone's kind of again. I was only there for a day, but I remember everyone seems very like jaded. I was there. Like, I was out to a beautiful restaurant. This person was playing piano. I was like, this is fantastic.
Yeah.
Everyone there was like, and I was like,
really?
What the fuck? Dude, we got the piano man rocking. Yeah. I'm tipping the piano man, obviously. I'm fucking hitting him with a five and maybe a 10. I'm drinking wine. I'm eating steak.
That's what I did.
I'm exactly.
Drank some wine, ate some steak.
That's how you do it.
And then I,
yeah,
I went to this one restaurant that's pretty nice. I forget what it's called. Baboa? Whatever.
French Laundry?
I'm not sure.
We had the French Laundry with the governor, Gavin Newsom.
No, I wasn't there. That cocksucker. Dude. That there's fucking nothing
hypocritical
more than that. Yeah, this is where I was. It was very nice. And it's...
Ooh.
Sweet Tim Dillon took me here, which was very nice.
Ooh.
And Tim's famous, which is funny to watch. That's all it was. It was TikTok kids, dude.
What the fuck?
That's what I was going to say. Why what? It's the... That's all I was going to say. I had no idea this article existed. Every single person in there was a group of TikTok famous people.
What the fuck?
And I was waiting for the baby girls to get in there so I could put my hands on them.
Yeah, I mean, I was would you say, yo, I've been serious looking. Question. Would you fuck a dude like that? Just on principle? Like, yeah.
I don't know, dude. Remember we talked about this like 2 years ago? All these dudes like box.
True.
You would think you'd see one of these sweet boys out and you'd be like, what's up, pussy? And then you get tagged up by one of
with
them.
With like a six piece combo. Like,
after they knock you out.
I don't know, dude. I think if you brought them the thunder, they'd fucking freeze up.
I do think
if you did like a full on cry spasm,
cry rage, rage run towards them in a fucking nice restaurant.
Like a screaming, what the fuck? Yeah, that they would. I think they'd freeze up, dude. Because again, a boxer, you know, they're ready. They're like, they need to keep their distance. If you just bum rush them while they're eating and fuck them, I don't think they'd be able to punch you off them.
It was funny. We were sitting next to, it was just a clearly big, fat Jewish agent.
Yeah.
And then six kids from a content house.
Really?
And I was just listening to that. Like, it was unbelievable.
What the fuck?
Like, talking about content house stuff.
So is that
I wonder if I can find, no, I looked for them. I couldn't find the boys.
There they are.
Look at these kids. We suck, dude. Our society fucking sucks.
This is what the real world did to people, dude. People thought there'd be no repercussions of reality TV. Now this is a viable path in life for people.
Yeah.
To just move in a house and just film yourself and sell like Tide. This is super normal stimuli.
Well, I guess what we're doing is pretty fucking ridiculous.
This is ridiculous. True. But again, it's like we get to go home. Like, you know.
Yeah.
We still straddle the line of having a normal life. People have ditched that altogether. And their life has become on the like internet.
Yeah.
It's pretty wild. I mean,
that might have been them, dude. What's this house?
Dude.
Sway. It couldn't have been a Sway house. I know those boys. I would have recognized that.
Lives rent free in a Bel Air mansion.
Yeah.
You have to meet your contact.
But at least like boy bands used to be able to, you know, steal black music and dance.
What are these guys? Don't these
They don't
do
anything. They just dance. They have abs and they dance.
What's Michael Gruden doing?
Okay. Well, figure it out before you Google it and make us fucking look at it, right? I like this boy. 3,400 followers. Shout out that guy. Damn. Oh, it's John Gruden's son.
Oh, shit, dude.
Baller.
He still has that same fucking intense look,
Yo,
too.
Yo, did you get to see Bill Belichick's son?
No, what happened?
Fire him up, dude. You're going to love this kid.
What's up with B.
You're going to be a fan of this, dude.
Wait till you see
this guy's fucking son.
I think
he coaches defense or special teams.
Oh my God,
He's a fucking beast.
Do you think that's like a thing coaches are conscious of?
He's the outside linebacker's coach. I'm an idiot. They were just showing him a lot because he's a son. And he has a mullet and makes fucking wild faces.
I mean, damn, dude.
That's football, bro.
That's what I'm talking about. Damn. Fuck, did he play ball?
I bet he played D3 if I had to guess.
Fuck, dude. Dude, is that hilarious?
It's good, dude. We've morphed into a bad podcast. Yeah, I like it. I we've officially ascended into making enough money to be a horrible podcast.
That's something I've been trying to do, though. I've been trying to stoke ire for like the Cowboys. When I found out the Eagles lost, I tried to get myself into a state of like,
I never cared.
Fuck.
When you're there, it's actually like, fuck these people.
Well, it is weird going to a nice stadium. I went to the Baltimore Ravens one time. Damn, that guy fucking rules,
M&T Bank?
Dude.
It's not, that's not nice.
What?
M&T Bank, I think.
It was nice, dude. Compared, I was, this is back, I think, when the
When it was new, it was pretty nice.
Yeah, there was like people calmly sitting watching the game.
That's what you meant. I thought you meant like the stadium, because Cowboys Stadium is like,
it's futuristic.
Fucking crazy.
Really?
It's crazy. Dang. You wouldn't believe it.
Yeah, if I saw people laughing at, you know, I don't know. I don't know how
I don't
react.
Like when people were laughing at my birds.
I don't know how
my birds
react.
Were down there having a bad time and all these dumb fucking Texas hicks.
Yeah, that's true. Well, we're a young fucking team, dude.
Young team. You're
we're
exactly
a young
right.
team.
Young
dude.
Team.
You know, so what can you expect, dude? We're on the road. We're a young team, you know.
Hell yeah.
Is football having the same problems basketball's having with people refusing unwisely to get the vaccine?
Yeah, there's a couple of players that are outspoken.
Really? Basketball's had a lot.
Yeah. Cam Newton, I think, was one of them. And that he got kind of released by the Patriots, and that was partly,
really?
I think, due to it.
Really? Yeah, there was a bunch of the...
I like that, The Atlantic. What most NFL players understand that Cam Newton doesn't. Thank you, yeah. The Atlantic, for trashing a guy's beliefs.
Dude, well, The Atlantic, dude, I get The Atlantic newsletter to my email. Dude, so they're saying, and you know, correct me if I'm wrong, but they're like, here's things, like moving forward, here's what we need to learn about the, you know, like going forward with like the coronavirus. We need to stop relying on the vaccine to stop spreading transmission. What?
Who wrote this? Who wrote this shit? Maxim? Yeah. Maxim, dude. Go away and die, dude. How dare you talk shit?
Yeah, dude.
Talking all Wentz. Wentz loves God. He loves Jesus, so he doesn't like the
vaccine. Give me the religious exemption, bro. Yeah, man.
And they're trashing him. A man whose own bones betray him at the slightest feathery touch.
Whoa.
Okay, fucking reporter.
Yeah.
Talking about an NFL quarterback that gets hurt.
Yeah, dude.
That tore his ACL diving for a touchdown. Adam Green. Let me see this fucking little
let's pull this guy up.
Fucking pussy face.
First man. Yeah. Oh, God. Hopefully.
Journo. Thank you.
What the fuck?
That's well, it could him. Be any of these guys. True. They're all pussies.
Usually if you click their Twitter right in the thing, Gardini, if you go to the article, click their Twitter, it'll pop. Oh, there you go. Click that man's.
He's
the fucking
his
coward.
Identity.
He hides.
Good for him.
He fucking hides. That's not him.
No, it's Maxim.
Law 360.
That shout guy out that guy. That's that guy a lawyer. Would, he would never talk shit on.
He knows better, dude, because that's you could sue.
An injury-prone NFL quarterback because
is
he's
that
not
him
getting
down
the
vax. Is that him down there? That looks like some little motherfucker that would write that kind of shit. I should.
He does look like that type of motherfucker.
I shouldn't bring that. There he is. I can fucking see that weasel from a mile away.
Dorky bullshit.
Bro, I'd go one-on-one with him.
How dare you talk about Wentz?
All right, give him the pigskin. Let me rush, dude. Let's see if his bones betray him.
If you Oklahoma drilled with Adam Green, you would fucking
let's go in the bull
stick
ring.
Him, dude.
Let's go in the bull ring. Sick meme. Let's go in the bull
ring. Yeah, he's got good memes.
Dude, if me and him did the bull ring. Did you do
and
the
gifts.
Bull ring in high school?
Yeah.
Dude. What do you think I do?
All this guy does is post GIFs. What's he, a boomer? I'm an LA podcaster now. Today's shit is sponsored by these bars. I get them at rest stops.
Dark chocolate. Dude,
And pure dark chocolate.
I feel like my body temperature has risen a degree.
Why?
Dude, I get amped on
the dark chocolate.
Bro. I'm like Montezuma.
You are.
Montezuma used to drink 30 goblets of dark chocolate a day.
What?
Yeah, dude.
What happened to him?
He invited some guys into his house.
And they kidnapped
him.
And
they fucking kicked his ass. Oh, dude, you reminded me of the A News, dude.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. We were talking about the Japanese.
Yeah, dude.
Beheading.
Dude, so I'm still reading my Joseph Campbell mythology book.
Nice.
So now I'm almost done prehistory. Now, next thing I think I'm going into is Asian, like they call it Asian, but it's Indian and all that stuff. It's bullshit, but
it's crap. They deserve better.
It's absolute crap. But dude, I'm getting towards the end of it, and they talk about the Ainus, and they were like white kind of, they're like these indigenous kind of like honky. They're not total honkies. It's a type in Ainu Japan. Just do ANU, and it'll autocorrect your ignorance. it's I. There's an I in there. But yeah, dude, they're visibly were mixed with like. Kind of like Siberian Russian dudes.
Mm.
And they live in Japan. They're like Japan's kind of Uyghurs. But they're like hunter-gatherers. And I don't think they get along very well with the Japanese people. I think there's a little bit of beef there.
A lot of this sounded pretty speculative, that entire description.
Well, I was Googling them to see what they looked like. And they were saying basically like, yeah, dude, there's a lot of...
Yeah, they're Russian there. Regions with... Yeah.
So
you got some Russians.
They're like some Ruskies that have been kicking around Japan. And... One of the things, there's one of their, look at that dude. One of their things they were saying, they
that guy looks pretty Japanese.
That guy up there?
Yeah.
I don't know, dude. It's not, I mean,
maybe the garb.
Don't be fooled by the emperor's beard, dude. They're all the last samurai. It's a nation of last samurais.
Just I would be. There.
Yeah.
You know?
That's
if we got nuked and everybody started making fucking video games and cartoons, I'd be like, no, dude, we had swords and shit.
Well, they
we don't
hung
have
on
to
it.
Be doing this.
Dude, one of their like customs, or they believe everything around them is a god, like every single thing, like rocks, everything. Like they're just like mountains or whatever.
So but they're wrong.
Well, you know, that's your fucking, you know, colonist approach. But they have bear, dude, they worship bears.
So they're wrong.
They worship, dude. This is what they, but here's what they do, which is fucked up. So if they find a baby bear out in the wild, this is like, if they just happen upon them, this is like turns the whole party up. So if they go out there, they find a baby cub, they bring it back, and the women all nurse it, they feed it breast milk. And like, so they raise this thing until the point it becomes, what's that?
A picture.
There it is. Dude, yeah. This is what they do. So this is part of the, like the thing. So they raise them, they nurse these things to the point where they're big enough to where they play with it, like if it can start to hurt you. So then they take it and lock it in a box and feed it like, I think like millet and, you know, fish for like 2 years. They let it get big, you know, like we do with cows here.
Yeah.
They feed it, let it get big. And then, dude, here it is. And then as soon as it it gets like of age, they sacrifice it because they're like, this is a god. We're releasing the mountain god back to itself in the form of a bear. So they just like get these two poles and put its head like here and trap it. Like, dude, they like literally four dudes wrestle it. And then a expert marksman shoots it in the heart with an arrow and kills it. And they cut its head off and make soup out of the bear and keep putting bowls of soup in front of its head. Like, when you go back to the afterlife, take all these gifts back and let them know that we treated you so well.
He's going to be pissed when he gets back.
No, they're in their head. They're like, isn't this a nice thing we're doing? And the women who nursed it are kind of like mixed emotions. They're like, some of them are crying.
I bet
they're
sad a little bit.
They are a little sad.
I'd be sad to see him go.
And they talk about it.
Especially nowadays. I'd be like, well.
There it is, dude. Yeah, man. The A-News.
Those tattoos, too. Those face, the makeup?
They show that the woman's of age. Yeah, those like, yeah, they that's how you know a woman's of age in the Ainu clan. If she's
well, that'd be nice. That would help us out.
I mean, they got a couple things figured out.
Save some, you know some people in our industry would have been helped.
I wouldn't want to go to the Ainu Zoo, though. That would be a tough place to visit. But they got the women. They got the thing. Dude, we should have women who are legal for sure. Like
just a Hitler's tattoo.
Barcode Hitler. That's what they said it was. In the book, they said it's just a bar of ink above all their noses. They give women a mustache so you know it's fucking lit.
Yeah.
It's on. If a woman has a tat stash, it's fucking on, dude.
Good for them. Those are all good.
Yeah, so they like wrestle a bear. They wrestle a 2-year-old bear and just fucking. And the marksman shoots it so it dies instantly at least.
Well, that's.
And then they cut its head off and they all chill with its head. And then, like, at their town center, they have a ton of like bear skulls that they like look at and they're like, yeah, dude, fuck, that was awesome.
That is cool. Good for them.
Pretty sick, man. They just eat bear soup and party until when the bear's totally eaten, the festival's over and they just go back to fucking whatever.
Back to chilling.
Back to exactly that. Squatting.
Back to sitting
on a
fucking board.
They just go back to squatting on plywood until they see another bear. And then turn it off.
Like, yo.
It's party time.
Everybody.
Yeah, dude. Isn't that fucking nuts?
It is nuts.
It's just fucking crazy. What is our thing is we just go to a bar and just get hammered.
That's a good one.
And fucking call puke in Ubers.
And then watch Notre Dame Cincinnati.
I scream, dude.
See, why does my team lose?
We just scream.
I scream into a pillow, dude.
Yeah, ticked. Man. That must have stunk, dude.
It did stink. I was pumped for that game. I was like, this will be a nice day.
Yeah.
And especially when you're out west and the game starts early.
Yeah.
Out west when football starts early in the morning.
Well,
it's great.
We'll start like 11 a.m.?
Yeah.
So it's nice. You took an L at like 1 in the afternoon.
Took an L early. Then I go to this club. Yeah. I do my new material.
Yeah.
It's not going. It worked. It went very well. Everybody liked it. One guy left, waited for me out at the bar.
What?
With him and his wife, stood out there. So I get out. This is the early show. I walk outside.
Yeah.
The next show is still in line, ready for the late show. They're standing by the bar. I'm walking by. Everybody enjoyed the show. So I'm taking pictures, doing all that. And then when I walk by this guy, he's like, worst fucking show I've ever seen in my life. And I thought I did so well, I thought he was kidding. I was like, oh, thanks, man. How are you? He's like, no, that was a piece of shit show. You're an asshole. And I was like, you're a fucking pussy, dude.
What?
And we had to kind of get separated. It was very weird.
What the fuck, dude?
Yeah, it was crazy. And it was in front of everybody getting ready to go into the next show. which is pretty funny.
Did you get dressed at the next one?
I did, and I was actually trying to figure out which party was mad at. That was the hardest part.
What do you think he was pissed about?
I have a joke about Navy SEALs, and I think that fired him up a little.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And that, which if you, you know, there's, he didn't understand the joke.
The nuance.
Which is annoying. Yeah. It always bothers me. Yeah. I always want to know why someone's upset. Or like what they think I thought.
He could just be an unstable dude, too.
He was obviously unstable. He spazzed and waited. Yeah.
That's crazy. That would be fun, though, if after the show you just got that all the time instead of people like, nice show. I'd be like, that fucking
It's nice to have a fight.
Yeah.
And then last night I got in two different fights.
What?
Yeah. I got in two fights. I did three shows. Two of them I got in fights.
After or on stage?
Both on stage.
What were the fights?
The first show, I was at the stand.
Yeah.
And there were three dudes talking the whole time. And every comedian that got off was like, oh, those guys won't shut the fuck up. But nobody said anything.
She attacked.
So I was like, are they black? And the girl was like, no. Because I knew that was the only reason every white comic would not say anything or be like, kick them out.
Yeah.
So then I was like, are you sure they're not black? Dude. So then I get in there and of course, yes. Yes.
They're also very fun. That's a very fun.
One of them was not. The one that was yapping the most was not an African American. So she was correct. And I wasn't being racist. I was making fun of white people for being scared to say anything. Yeah. But
dude, fighting black hecklers might be the funnest
thing in comedy. Dude. I was fuming already because I have to do a fucking roast.
Yeah.
I'm not happy about it.
Yep.
So all I was doing, I found out I was doing the roast for the next 10 hours. I was just saying the meanest things I could think of in my head about all my close friends.
That's good.
Which is a terrible thing to do. And then thinking about what they're going to say to me and me being like, what the fuck? Like, I was just mad.
You should be like, guys.
I can't be on a roast.
No, you should tell them, like, guys, like, it's going to be fun, but you mind if I kind of, like, write your jokes about me?
Yeah.
Like, Shane's dick is so big.
Yeah, yeah. So
just gets in the way of everything.
I get on stage, and I was fuming going in there.
Yeah.
And these three dudes are talking. 20 seconds into my set, I was like, yo, shut the fuck up, dude. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't like even, it wasn't even close to like,
visibly angry.
Yeah. That's exactly what I said on stage. Oh. I was like, this is a good way to do stand up. Cause after I was like, yo, shut the fuck up. He was like, yo, you want to go outside? I was like, yeah, we can go outside. You fucking idiot. Or we can kick you out right now.
Who threatened to fight you?
The dude who was talking to us. Yeah. I think he might have been Hispanic.
Really? But he was Zimmerman.
He was a bit of a GZ.
He's a Zimmerman.
Yeah, he stood his ground on the heckle. I'll give him that. But I'm going to go George Zimmerman. But actually, yes, that's actually exactly what he looked like.
There you go.
Jesus,
that's a hot take, Zimmerman in court.
So this kid, and it got like heated. I was like, yeah, we can. Or I can just kick you the fuck out, dude. Shut up.
Yeah.
And the crowd was like, they like clapped because they were annoyed. But then that was the first minute. And I had to be like, all right. So I'm seeing this girl, like I had to like go into stand up, but it ended up being good. And eventually he laughed, which was funny. And I was like, I need to laugh, you fucking idiot. And then I get off stage and they're like, cause I had to walk by them and they're like, yo dude, sorry about that. Our man's actually, he's thinking about becoming a stand up.
Oh, of course.
And
of
I was
course.
Like, well, shut the fuck up. It shows you fucking, I was like, it was that fight adrenaline on stage, which is the worst.
Yeah. It's bad energy.
So then I get to the cellar and I'm doing a joke and I start the Special Olympics joke. And this girl's like, no, she was sitting me to this chair, like right here, that close to the stage.
Dude, you should just dive on her.
And I was like, what's wrong? And it's just loud out there. It's not a big deal.
What is it?
Probably Billy watching something.
Fuck.
It's not a big deal. Even if it picks
up. Turn that crap off.
Edit this out. Bill, damn it. I'm not going to yell it. I'm not going to raise my voice.
True.
I've been fuming already.
True.
So I get, after that fight, I go to the cellar, get in a fight with a lady who's like, no, you can't talk about this. And then, you know, battled her. Went to war.
How'd you win?
I did win. The crowd liked it. Yes. I won.
Yes, dude. Yes.
It was nice. And her boyfriend liked me. That was the best part. He was laughing. Yes, that was it.
Why do they think that they can do that?
I'm not sure. She was like, she was like, with some of my family, or I have a family member that was in the Special Olympics. Don't you feel like a dick? And I was like, not at all.
Yeah.
I was like, did you hear what I said? Like, I was like, are you a fucking retard? But it was nice because it was a show where two black dudes came up on, well, Sypha Sounds and Will Sylvance. I shouldn't describe them that way.
Yeah.
And Sypha's not black. But they at the end of your set, they come on and talk with you. I don't know, fucking Puerto Rican or something. ahead. You know, yeah. It's all Greek to me. I don't know if that's how that saying applies, but yeah, his scythe. And so it was nice because they come up and like talk with you after the set. So we all got to.
That's fine.
Now I had allies. Now I had people of color.
Powerful allies.
Now
dude.
I had POCs as my allies.
True.
And they were like, lady, you're a fucking idiot. It was nice. Big win.
That's
got
a huge
two fights last night. So something's wrong with me, probably.
No, I don't think so. I think you did the right thing.
I've been going around battling.
Yeah. You've been on the road for a month, bro.
I've been,
been on the road for
calling
a month.
Calling a guy a fucking pussy to his face after the show. That was crazy.
Well, he
was like worst fucking show I've ever seen in my life. But normally I'd just be like, all right, whatever. But I was actually like, yo, you're a fucking you're a fucking pussy. It was crazy.
How big was he?
He was big. It would have been a problem.
That would have been a
problem.
But
there was also.
That would have been Godzilla versus Megalodon, dude.
It would have. We would have been bumping everybody out of the way.
It would suck to have to break up a fight with two big guys. Stop.
It would suck to have a fucking black eye before my late show.
True.
Just get on stage and be like, how do you guys like it more than the last crowd liked it?
The reveal would have been sick, dude.
Yeah.
You could have kept your back to the audience and been like,
turn around with a bloody face.
Yeah,
like, the last crowd didn't like the show. No, dude. It was funny to go on stage and be like, I'm trying to figure out what that guy was mad at. So
yeah,
let's hear where you think.
Yeah, if any of you guys hate this.
Tell me where you think somebody could have been so angry that they tried to fight me.
Yeah, dude.
It was funny.
That's actually,
within the first joke, people were like, that's it. That was probably it. I was like, yeah, that might have been it.
That's very
funny. That was fun. We had a good time.
Speaking
of stand-up's so damn fun, dude. I love it.
It is fun. Speaking of stand-up, kind of like those types of scenes and the drama around it, I started Sam Talen's book.
Oh, it's a phenomenal book,
dude,
right?
I told it's insane. I did the audio book. And I was like, it was... Like, you know, writer stuff, dude. The prose.
Is unbelievable.
It's so good. I was like, bro, my eyes have to see this.
Yeah.
I got to do, I was like, the audio form was flying by me and I was like, nah, I got to see that. My eyes have to see that on the page.
Yeah.
Order the hard copy, bro. Dude, I'm telling you.
He'd
man,
be so pumped to know you were
reading. I told him
it. Oh, good.
I told him, I messaged him. I said, bro, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah, Sam's awesome.
Like, really, really good. I mean, the story's
shockingly good.
The story's fantastic, but it's like, I'm listening to little turns of phrases, and I'm going, by dumb it, bro. That's a fucking
Dadgum, the boy can write.
Goddamn, the boy can write. And dude, I'm telling you, pause the audiobook and say, and I'm an audio. I'm like, I can listen to anything. I was like, my eyes have to grace these on the paper, dude.
Mm.
I was like, this is good.
What a nice thing.
Yeah, I was blown away. I was in a Chicago hotel room.
Just like, reading.
My infant next to my baby next to me, my babe. And I'm just, oh, dude, that's the best, dude. At the end of the day.
Really?
Finally fucking plugging into some audio.
I do like it. I do that with Bloodlands every night.
I started Bloodlands.
It's not fun, is it?
I get, like, I'm waiting to get into, like, the real specifics of it.
Yeah.
It hit me with the fucking, like.
Oh, the numbers
up
front.
In Russia.
Yeah, dude.
It just puts me to sleep.
You have to plow through that. And it does put me to sleep, which is
nice.
It does. You got to plow through that where they're, like, in Kazakhstan on, April of 1938.
They give you a little taste, though. I got a little taste.
There's some taste, dude.
I was like, yes.
Yeah, you get laid in there.
It's a carnage, yes.
And it is no good.
It's pretty horrendous, dude.
Dude, you got to look up what those boys were doing to Belarus.
What are they up to?
No good.
What are they up to?
Just bad.
I didn't even know. Belarus is like a, what is that, a country?
Yeah. It's
Belarusian.
It's kind of, it's
what
next.
What does Belarusian look like?
Polak, Russian.
Right.
Yeah.
I thought about that. How
the Polaks and the Belarusians got their fucking shit rocked.
Yeah, dude. Poland's kind of like Ukraine in that like it gets like just taken over at will.
Look at the Belarusian babes, dude.
Although, god damn.
Oh, Simonas. Simonas. Whatever her name was.
Yeah, what the? Oh, dude, that's fighting words. Showing Putin kissing a man?
Well, they don't know who they like.
What do you mean?
Because that's what happened in World War II. They were like, the Germans were controlling it. The Russians were controlling it. They just had to fucking keep switching sides to stay alive. Like all the partisans, all the freedom fighters and shit. But at one point, it got to this where the Germans had this plan to literally eradicate Eastern Europe and use it as like farmland for Germany.
Jesus.
So they were literally like, let's just kill everyone.
Didn't they pretend to be their boys too?
Yeah.
That's so dastardly, dude.
It is a little
bit. That Hitler was a pain in the ass, dude.
I'll tell you what, the more I read
Hitler
about
was an asshole.
The more I read about this guy, not as cool as, you know, your brother thinks. But
turns out he was a jerk.
So at one point they ran out of manpower in Germany to like work the farms to make the foods because
they
were sending all their troops to just kill people.
Yeah, right.
So they sent these dudes all their troops to Belarus. All the guys were in Belarus. So they sent Belarusian men. They shipped them back to Germany to work the farms so that the soldiers could stay in Belarus and kill the women and children.
Jesus,
and the
dude.
Sick people. They're like, well, we're going to be hungry for this.
So I would be like, I'll take the sick people.
Yeah.
Like, you mind if I just kill us? I don't feel like killing anyone.
I forget the name of it.
Today.
There was a battalion, a German battalion that was made of criminals and murderers and psychos, and their job was literally just to kill civilians in Eastern Europe.
What?
Wild, dude.
What? That's fucked up, dude. Waffen-Grenadier. Or Black Hunters. Damn.
Yeah, dude. That's the guy. Oscar Derlewanger. It was bad. They were not expected by Nazi Germany to survive their service. So they were just sent over there to... They just surround... The whole chapter is just them surrounding villages, rounding everyone up, putting them in a barn, lighting it on fire, going to the next village.
They pretended to be their boys. That's the biggest travesty.
Oh, they backstabbed them?
Yeah.
It'd always be the closest to you.
True.
You know
true
what I mean?
That. True that, dude.
They were over there like, damn, this some good Belarus pussy.
Hey, you guys like want to win a war together? I don't
know.
Yeah,
you guys want to team up against the Soviets?
Like, hey, you guys take care of us. We'll go over there and make sure you guys are good. They're just burning everyone alive.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty fucked up, man.
Yeah.
That's what happens when you take religion out of society, actually.
Yeah.
Well, you know,
I think
religion did that too.
I think the Germans had a little bit of religion.
They were worshiping like ancient aliens, though. They were worshiping George Stukulos.
That's kind of...
there he is, dude. There's a patron saint.
Yeah,
of
this thing is
Germany.
A complete distraction.
True. It is
I'm
tough.
Just looking at it like, oh, yeah, there he
you
is.
You end up doing like an hour and 30. You don't even realize how much time goes by.
Yeah.
But the... yeah, dude, that's some like level one jerk stuff. When did the Belarusians...
Man, this is... You are headed to Giorgio. This is...
George Stiegler?
This is you, year one of the podcast. Here's where we're at. It's coming.
Oh, yeah. Of Stiegler?
That's you, dude.
Yeah, I mean, dude, it's very possible. It's very,
and I'll be
there
honest.
There he is. There is. That's him fucking getting dappered up.
Yeah.
That's more
that's
me.
You,
that's
year
my
one.
Speed, bro. That's me at the wedding, dude. My hair is slowly shows up.
Please do that. Damn, George's not looking good. Season 13, he's been boozing.
He got that alien money, dude.
The boy's been partying with the alien money.
He's probably every night going home, like, people think I'm fucking full of shit.
Everybody makes fun of me.
People don't think I know about fucking aliens.
I wonder if he begs the aliens to visit, if he prays to them at night.
Every single day. There's his head.
Please, dude.
He's like, here's my dad's skull.
What a fucking gig that guy turned out. Like, I mean, what a life, dude. He was able to turn that into, like, sick shit. Just getting on and lying.
Imagine the pussy he got. Imagine how many fucking pieces of serpentine he got, dude.
I mean, this just gives me love and releases bad
He probably
titty-fucked
serpentine. He probably just got two big, smooth crystals. $4 million? Okay.
$4 million. All right, Georgie.
I see you, Georgie, bro. I see you, Georgie.
That's pretty good.
Damn, dude. He's a Greek-Austrian. Yeah, dude. I mean... he doesn't even need sources. That guy can just be like, dude, you don't think aliens talk to the Mayans? And everyone's like, I could see that.
Yeah.
It's like, obviously.
Zero. So my favorite thing, and I think that it's just funny because I was just in Arizona and I think about Soder all the time because Soder gets high off his ass like every night. So me and Soder, I used to go to his house every day because he lived right next to me. And one night he was high watching Ancient Aliens.
Nice.
And he lived in Arizona for a while. He went to Arizona and at one point, they're like,
dangerous place for a stoner to be, dude.
It is.
Dangerous place.
Quickly elevates to crystal meth. Quickly. But we were watching Ancient Aliens. Soda's just sitting in like the corner of an L-shaped couch, just in gym shorts, curled up. Like. And at one point, they're like, in Tacoma or Sedona, Arizona. And he goes, Sedona. I was like, dude, that's the highest thing I've ever seen anyone do.
Sedona's a
like getting a Sedona shout out on Ancient Aliens
Sedona
and being pumped and just sitting there like, Sedona.
I was like, dude, Sedona is fucking a very mystical place.
It is.
A lot of the YouTube health mystical health coaches I watch live in Sedona.
The mystical health coaches should be thrown off one of these. They should be thrown off one of these natural.
Yeah, I'd
bridges.
Like to see you throw Paul Check off and fucking gorge.
Look,
Sedona,
I'm not going
to
go
I'd
near
love to
that
see you
fucking
throw
idiot.
Certified health nut off there.
I'd like fucking what's his name?
You
who's
probably,
the?
Yeah, I would love to see you throw Paul Check, dude. He would. Oh my god,
Paul Check's a fucking
dude,
dildo.
He trained.
Is this a guy punching himself in the dick?
No, that's certified health nut.
Certified health nut. All right. I apologize, Paul Check.
Paul Check, dude. Check has multiple wives, by the way. He's got two fucking wives, dude. He stacks rocks. Is that him with fucking... I thought that was the dude from the Vampire Show who also beats his wife. The Vampire Show. No, the dude who beats his wife.
The guys from Vampire Shows are nowhere else.
No, he was on Big Lie.
What's Big Lie?
Or what's the fuck? Big Little Lies or whatever it's called?
Big Lie.
Big Little Lies, dude. It's the dude.
Sedona.
Dude, I'm telling you, if Sedona's where I'm thinking of, all these guys live out there.
Sedona's great.
But Sedona is like LA for TikTokers, but it's just dudes being like, hey guys, try this chlorophyll. Yeah, Big Little Lies. Who's that? Where's that? There he is. Skarsgård, bro.
He was on True Blood.
He was on True Blood. Yeah. I think he beat the shit out. I think every role he takes.
And he was Tarzan. He white faced. Damn. He did what? Yeah. Dude.
Did you hear Sarah Silverman came at people for Jew face?
Oh, really?
Yeah, she's calling
she
out.
She should be quiet because go actors. Ahead and type in what she did.
What'd she do? Oh, boy.
No, I was going to go with blackface, but sure. She's got a vicious blackface, dude.
Really?
Yeah, of course.
Yee! What was that about?
Yeah, she's got a pretty vicious one.
2019?
Oh, who put that on? Comedy Central? How about that?
What the heck?
That's an old... I'm sure there was some...
Maybe she was getting married.
I'm sure it was nuanced.
Maybe she was getting married.
She could have been marrying an African-American.
Yeah, she could have been... Fuck, that one.
I'm beautiful. I look like Queen Latifah.
Damn, dude.
Oh, no.
Is that what she... you know, look, I don't want to engage in the slander and... fucking game, but yeah, I just, you know, I personally thought she had some good takes.
Oh, she got fired from a movie role, so she's all right. She paid for it.
What movie was she fired from?
Roots.
Look, the optics.
The optics aren't great. We're gonna have to let you go.
That's
she entered a Baptist church with that face. Good Lord.
How do they talk so many of these people into doing this? There's so many people in the
90s. I don't know. That's what I've always said. Like the blackface thing, like people are like, oh, it was different back then. It's like, dude, I was from a white town.
Yeah.
Surrounded by nobody that was woke. And even I would be like, don't do that.
Yeah, don't
like do I blackface. Instinctively was like, that's bad.
Yeah. I remember one time one of my old roommates fell asleep. And I was
dude, click the one with her at the fucking church. Good Christ.
Yeah, that's pretty nuts, man. How did they?
So, what was she saying about Jew face?
She was saying there's a lot of white women like playing Jewish women, and how it needs to stop.
I bet. I don't want to bash her because I think she might be actually.
Well, yeah, she wasn't. I mean, I'm not bashing. I didn't know she had that.
No, I think she actually might be cool.
I'm sure,
I
she
could
is
be
cool.
wrong.
I mean, you know.
She was cool enough to do that fucking shit earlier in her career. She was doing some pretty cool
shit. I was a fan of the Sarah Silverman. When I used to watch the Sarah Silverman show, I liked it.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's a babe, dude. Babe's fucking
and she had a special called Jesus is Magic that I thought, when it came out when I was a younger man, I thought it was funny.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it in a long time.
I used to love love her, too.
And she is very attractive.
I used to love
her. I've never seen her look better than the pictures we were just looking at.
Yeah, I used to love her a lot.
Yeah.
No, I was just... Yeah, representation fucking matters, bro. That's...
Wait. So here's the problem. Yeah. I'm not going to read this article.
Yeah, don't. It's stupid.
But no, I'm saying don't close it. But she probably... This is something I've got to avoid because it happened to us.
That's what I'm saying.
A headline and you're like, oh, this fucking idiot. Look at this dumbass.
Yep.
And then you don't know that the article is probably like... I don't know. She might have been joking.
Could have been.
Although she does seem pretty serious
as of late. I think it was on a cast.
She does seem pretty serious lately.
Yeah, but still...
I think the Jews, I don't want to step out of line here.
What?
They may be overrepresented in Hollywood and comedy. Now, I could be wrong. Where did I get that from?
Did you look at that chart on the internet of all the media corporations?
Is there a chart? I'd like to see the chart.
There's a nice little flow chart kicking around. don't look at it, dude.
Don't look at it. Don't put it up.
I mean, you know, good on them, man.
That's their industry.
They figured it out.
Yes.
You know?
Good.
My dad and his brothers had a trash company. I don't
exactly.
Know.
If someone was like, there's too many Jews in the trash industry.
Yeah, don't let people pick up like the Irish cops, you know, yeah. On the Eastern Seaboard. Just lobby. Yeah. That'd be a nasty flow chart.
Yeah. We're all
Yeah, no, I don't. Look, dude, I don't get in a tizzy over this stuff. I saw
Damn, I like that picture. What? Nick Cannon calls out the boys, dude.
Who'd he call out?
He's called them all out. Jimmy Kimmel, Jimmy Fallon, Sarah Silverman. Look at him. Yikes. Cannon's the man, dude.
Dude,
you were right about this. I'll give you this. You were on Cannon well before I was.
Cannon's the boy, dude. Yes. Yeah, dude. The fact that I think Cannon, he's a lot of, he's like six kids.
The Cannon.
I think he has a PhD.
A lot of these guys become doctors.
And they cancel him, dude.
A lot of these guys lie about being doctors.
Well, where the hell did you get that from?
What the hell are you talking about?
Yeah, dude. Maybe it was a master. I think you got me and Cannon. I think have master's degrees.
The Cannon.
You got a degree.
Did you get your master's?
Yeah, I got my fucking master's, bro.
What are you fucking? I don't.
What the hell? You don't think I got my master's? The hell you?
I'm not sure. So you?
Are you gonna get your
PhD?
I thought about it.
You should be
not in social work. I might get my PhD in
religious studies. Who is this person? Ted Danson. Yo, didn't I know this is blackface? Is I don't like digging this up.
Yeah, true.
But
what did Whoopi have to say about it?
Didn't
really?
He's having that. What about what about what about who was the guy? Is it Billy Crystal? Somebody's album covers used to be just them blackface.
Really?
See if it was Billy Crystal. There was like,
how is this so rampant back then,
I don't know, dude. They loved doing blackface.
My thing is, dude, I forgive and forget. Billy Crystal, there he is up there. He won Tropic Thunder, actually.
Maybe I was wrong about Billy's comedy album something. Yeah, he's just doing he's having fun there. That's an impression. That's not as bad.
Yeah, that's...
That's not as bad.
Yeah, he Tropic Thundered.
How about... I found this out. So Bubba Wallace just won Talladega. They were like, he's actually the second African-American to win a NASCAR race. Wait till you see the first guy.
What?
He literally is just John C. Reilly.
Where?
He's not black, dude. What? Type in first NASCAR winner. First black. First black, yeah. He literally looks exactly like John.
What the fuck?
He is John C. Reilly. Go to the...
What? Go to that one in the middle, right?
Yeah,
there.
That one. No, one over.
Over.
To the right.
You buffoon.
That is John C. Reilly. They were like, NASCAR has been progressive for years. Here's our first black winner. His name is Wendell Scott, so he's got the name for it. I'm not trying to say this guy's not black.
You're not gonna
disparage this man's legacy.
If you saw this guy using the N-word, you'd be alarmed.
If that guy was saying the N-word at the track, at the track, it was safe space.
On the track, though, if you're driving
within the lines, if you're in the infield of a track, you can say it.
True that.
No, you can't. Don't do it.
Well, no one can hear it at 400 miles an hour. True. I think it's like a speed of light thing. It's like it doesn't exist.
You got to time it for when
the word
come
just
by.
Stops. Yeah. It's like if you go over the speed of light, you stop aging.
Yes.
If you're hitting like 350 on a curve, you let it slip, it just doesn't come out of your mouth.
Yep. Unless you're online playing video games.
True. Yeah, that's.
And then you have to go to Williams Grove for a year.
Yeah, he's back.
Yo,
in, he's
have
back
you seen what the boy's been doing?
He's been winning.
Young Money?
Young Money's been winning.
Young Money, Kyle Larson is dominating.
In the dirt track?
No, he's back in NASCAR and he's in first.
What?
By like a lot.
Dude, he went back to the fucking track, dude.
He went back to Williams Grove and found his roots.
You know how many people probably on the track would like love to have gone and rediscovered themselves like that?
What the hell happened? What's this?
What's that?
Second in the Cup Series.
He's 37.
Oh, you're
dude.
Looking. That's one particular race.
Oh, okay. So your boy's a motherfucking bum. He's 37.
No, no, no. Cup Series standings right there at the bottom.
He's 37.
Jesus Christ. Are you blind? Are you a fucking blind idiot? Yeah, I'm a blind idiot. Wait, are you actually struggling?
It's time.
Denny Hamlin's in first now? What the fuck?
Danny Hamlin, dude, yeah.
Larson's rocking that Chevy, dude. Second place. Ah, damn, how'd I know he drove a Chevy?
Oh, second place.
16 top five finishes. Don't call it a six wins. Look at everybody else's win total. 2-6-1-1-4-3-2. Dude.
He's fired up.
He's fired up. He's pissed.
He was crushing the track. That was just...
Think about being Young Money. You're in NASCAR. You get fucking kicked out.
I mean, what kind of money do you think he... That was probably a loss of a lot of money.
He probably lost a lot of money.
He went from making probably hundreds of thousands of dollars to like $400 a week.
Oh, no. He made a lot of money.
In the dirt track?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess his merch, yeah. Damn.
Kyle Larson is worth $12 million. He still flies commercial, though.
Yeah, yeah. I'm cheap.
Dude, Young Money.
That's
how do you not love him?
It's hilarious.
Now I can understand some people not liking him.
True.
For certain things.
On the video game sphere.
In the video game sphere, I could be like
PewDiePie pulled out.
PewDiePie's all right. I mean, no, don't play it, dude. Don't do my man like that. Don't you dare disparage him.
There he is.
Look at that handsome devil, dude.
Yeah, he found out, bro.
He did find out. He's a Cali boy.
Is he really?
Yeah, he's California way.
Wow.
Nickname's Young Money. Pretty tight.
Dang. Bro. All
right. Well, bro. We might have to switch over.
To the page?
To the page. Where Google. I'll tell you what.
See, I told you time goes fast.
Google, this could be a negative experience for the audio listeners. I'll tell you that.
No, us, for what?
Us just like, look that up, click that. Oh, shit, look at him.
No, it'll be, trust all me. Right. It's not as much time as you think. It's a relaxed environment, dude. This is a fast-paced environment at first. This is a relaxed environment.
Right of now. Course it's relaxed. Matt, I couldn't be cooler.
True.
I'm cooler than a cucumber right now.
Cool as hell, dude.
I've got serpentine in my hand. Yeah. All my negative thoughts are going straight into this rock. Now, if you broke this open, it'd be terrifying.
Yeah, man.
The thoughts that would come out.
I did.
That have been absorbed by this. I almost don't want to hand it to you because what you'd feel.
I'll just start like thinking about Clemson. Like, fuck Clemson.
God damn, Clemson. We can't make the playoff. God damn it.
Fucking didn't cover the spread. Miss the field goal. Miss the spread.
I am getting into betting, which is fun.
Yeah, you like betting?
I like betting and losing. I lose
you just
a lot.
Like losing?
I money? Like losing money so I can be around the fellas and be like, God damn, I don't even want to tell you how much money I just
really?
Lost on this. You know, it's fun to do that.
You like that?
I like losing money publicly.
And being like, ah.
What the hell? It's just money.
Yeah. Or like, come on. Yeah.
Ah, damn shit. It.
You have like a folded up program. Brochure.
Yeah. Yeah. I was watching Squid Game. Have you seen any of that? Mm-mm. Well, the opening scene is them going to like a Korean horse betting.
That's got to be fun.
It looked like the
what
most
fun. What are you betting
fun.
How fast they can eat them? Kidding. Jokes.
Edit it out.
That's a dark chocolate. Dude.
That's the dark chocolate speaking. But boy, that was funny. Anyway, that's a walk-off. This probably should be the end of the podcast.
The Black Widow. Yeah. That's how the Black Widow can eat so many cheese.
You know
things.
How we have Nathan's hot dog eating contest? They just have Nathan's that dog eating contest. That's a good joke. Actually, Korea just outlawed eating dogs. Thank
just
you.
Now?
Yep.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Korea.
Was that from North? That was North Korea mandate or South?
South. I'm Korea.
North still part.
North
yeah.
Korea is munching the dags.
Well, they got food problems over there.
They're though. Struggling with food, dude. They're munching the dags. There's nothing funny about that.
Dude, that debate must be.
Yo. Oh my God. Can we please get the debate? Especially with the translator's voice, like slowly translating it. Like fuck. For years, dog eating has been good here.
Yeah, is there any?
No, don't even show it.
They're not going to show the debates.
I don't like.
It probably wasn't even a debate. The debate was. It's probably, you ever see like Ukrainian Congress? They fist
yeah,
fight?
They're getting fist fights.
It was probably. Yeah, it was probably. Dude, imagine if they outlawed chicken on you, dude. To be
if
fair,
they outlawed wings.
To be fair,
of course. That's like, the thing. Like America, we're like, what do you eat dogs? It's like, yeah, they munch dogs, dude. Yeah. They're dogs. Who cares?
True.
Now we like dogs, but they don't care. So let them munch.
Does anyone have a dog over? I think they have dogs. It's
that's
like having
it,
a goat.
That's what it
like
says here. It says South Korea considers ban on eating of dog meat as pet ownership grows. So a couple people got dogs. We're like, oh, these guys rule. What the fuck are we doing?
So your grandpa's like pussy.
Yeah.
If like if you like keep a dog, like, dude, munch that thing. Pussy.
Yeah. If everybody in our country had like a pig in their house, they'd be like, all right, we got to outlaw eating pigs.
True. Pigs
these guys
are
great.
Pigs are pretty funny too. And also eating horses is very noble too. I've been reading a book about like, I think it was just a video, but I've been reading along this vein of like people just like dropping out of society and like living kind of off the grid. And one guy was like, I eat nothing but horse meat for like a year.
Really?
Yeah. Horse meat. Apparently it's like warrior food.
That makes sense. So, they used to munch horses a lot.
So what people could take as an insult really was just a compliment for me, honestly.
So true. Like, and so was mine. And see, this is how we've grown as a podcast.
True.
Because normally we would have been like, what are they eating dogs? And now we're like, let's go into it and explore this.
True.
And explain the cultural
let's
implications.
Yeah, let's
of this.
Grow, dude.
We'd like to grow as a podcast.
Like that horse back there, that's warrior food, dude.
That is warrior food.
Just
the Huns.
I mean, yeah, dude. Just chomping you, just chomping down. What the fuck? What the kind of racist bullshit is this from the Atlantic? A troubled history of horse meat. But hey. Dude. Dude, the Atlantic sent a thing recently about the being like, you know, tips we learned from this wave. Like, basically, like, we learned that we failed. They said every fucking day. They're like, we failed. Whatever whatever, what was the last thing called? Delta was a test and we failed. It's like, what are you talking about?
Dude, yeah.
They're like,
I don't like them.
We need to stop relying on the vaccine to slow the spread. It was never invented to prevent infection. It was prevented to reduce hospitals. It's like, you guys said in the beginning it was supposed to fucking slow. Dude, it's insane.
I saw a nice montage of all those politicians, like Pelosi and Biden and all of them being like, we're not going to mandate the vaccine. That's unconstitutional. We're never going to do that.
Yeah, man.
That was like 5 months ago.
Dude, I saw an article recently about there was like, they're talking about this guy. He used to be.
Oh, this is great. Me and the O'Con man have been battling.
Really?
Now I'm back off the road. Me and him sit on a couch and I'm like, see how fucking dumb Democrats are? And then he's like, But I was like, watch this clip. And it was Biden being like, I'm not going to do that. We're not going to mandate the vaccine.
Yeah.
And then I was like, that was 7 months ago. Now here he is. And he's like, we're mandating it for every federal employee, every company with over 100 employees.
Yep.
And Chris was like, well, it's not a government mandate. He's just saying if you work in the federal government. Like, that's how that's how he argues. I'm like, dude, what the fuck are you talking about?
It's a federal mandate.
I'd like to kill Chris.
You going to kill him?
Yeah, he's giving me a ride back to New York after this.
You should kill him on the drive.
I might grab the wheel.
I'll sit in the back and just Luca Brasi him, dude. Right as he parks the car safely.
I should shove my serpentine down his throat.
My serpentine. Dude, that'd be fucked. Yeah, there was an article I was reading about. They were like, this guy wrote a book on what we should do. And it was like, it was the ex-director of the FDA. And he was director of the FDA up until 2019. Now he's on the board at Pfizer.
Mm.
Not exactly a lateral move.
Yeah.
Like, we like the way you policed us, gave us guff. How about you hop on the board?
And you got it.
Yeah, pretty nuts.
I just want the government to have more power and say over what I do with my body.
I want corporations to have more. I want them to just fully overpower the government.
You know what I like them. Is when how hypocritical both sides are. That's what I like the most. What do you mean? Like people on the right or
Republicans always right. What are you talking about?
Like women being like, it's my body, my choice with abortion.
That was fun.
And then vaccine people are like, my body, my choice. The government can't tell me what to put in my body. And both sides are like, yes, they can.
I know. I started thinking that was almost planned. For a second, I was like, are Republicans doing this shit just to like throw that into the mix? Or this is what I'm kind of thinking. I think they're going to boogeyman Dems they're going to keep that abortion thing. That abortion thing's going to keep popping up around like vote time.
That's not good for the Republicans.
What?
The majority of the country is.
Well, the people who vote, choice. People who vote are geezers, though. Most people are pro-choice, but the geezers vote, and a lot of the geezers.
Yeah, but not anymore. Now we got the mail-ins, bro.
Yeah. You don't reference the big lie, bro. I'll kick this thing off the thing. You reference the big lie,
see what
dude.
The fuck happens.
Dude, you reference the big... You better not reference the big lie, dude.
What lie?
The big lie.
The mail-ins?
The big lie. Dude, what the fuck are you doing? Dude?
Mail-in ballots rule.
Don't reference the big fucking lie. There's the big lie, and there's no FDA. You fuck better not, dude.
You don't like this stuff.
No, I mean, not until as soon as it passes through the FDA, I say, oh, my God. Yeah, the big lie is, what the hell?
Trump's big lie, White History Month.
That's not the big lie. What would White History Month be?
White History Month?
Yeah.
It's every other month, man. You guys have it all the time. Yeah, now, that was a Mexican impression.
True. But yeah, they're saying like, election fraud stuff. I don't fucking know. Whatever, dude.
Guys, this thing's run its course. Are you happy I'm back?
Woo!
No.
I mean, it's all just for the page, bro.
Now it's time to get to the Patreon. Join the Patreon, dude.
Patreon, we do it for
now. We're going to turn the jets on.
That's how it goes.
We might even get Billy up here. Who knows? Might get Bill. Might get somebody.
Might just fuck around.
Might just be you and me.
Might just fuck around and find out, bro.
Having fun.
Yeah, dude.
God bless.
Yeah, man.
See you.